Thank you, everyone, for coming today. It's great to see so many people come out. That was Bach's Fantasy and Fugue in G Minor, which is my favorite Bach organ work, so that's why I wanted to share that with you today. If you can hear, the fugue subject just dances through that, so it fits especially appropriate if you were here this morning and heard Ron's sermon. The next two pieces are a set of short Gregorian preludes by Jeanne de Messier. Jeanne de Messier was one of the first women to hold an international career as both an organist and performer and composer. She wrote some of the most virtuosically challenging works in the repertoire, namely her six etudes and her Te Deum, which I've played before here. The Gregorian preludes show a different side of her, a much more tender, gentle side, and a side that can be easily used in church. Tu es Petrus is a march, as the French says, and it's done that shows that she takes the chant and works it into that style of music. Then Berceuse means lullaby, and Domine Jesu is a sweet, gentle, rocking lullaby. So that the next two pieces are premieres of original compositions, which I love sharing new music with people. So I was really excited this past January when a friend of mine from undergrad organized a big project to commission new works for whatever instruments, and I signed up for it and got these following two pieces, one by Jeremy Esquire, who is with us today from University of Michigan. Okay. And then Impressions on a Field of Fresh Falling Snow by Dayton Hare, who is not with us because he's spending his summer in Paris, I believe. These pieces have some wonderful text painting. In Jeremy's piece, you will hear, I will actually be reciting Bible verses into a microphone as I play, and you can hear the music reflect the beginning of creation. And then Dayton's piece comes with this poem, which I'm going to read to you now. After the storm, tree boughs slouch with snow-laden limbs. Alone, the frost eats pine smoke air and swallows silence, as frigid solitude is broken by a fox's footfalls on the field. So it'll be a little bit of winter in July, which I'm sure will be a relief after the humidity we've been facing. So enjoy the De Messier Gregorian Preludes, The Word of God by Jeremy Esquire, and Impressions on a Field of Fresh Fallen Snow by Dayton Hare. Thank you.
in the beginning. Beginning. God created the heaven and the earth. Continuing with short pairs of pieces, the next two Brahms chorale preludes are both from Brahms' collection of 11 chorale preludes that he wrote, all taking various Lutheran chorales and setting them in various ways. The first, O Gott, du frommer Gott, means, O God, thou faithful God.
And you can hear the chorale quietly emerges in the midst of this very twisted, chromatic, weaving lines, showing God's faithfulness, which I thought in the chimes of church Speedway going through transition, showing God's faithfulness was a very appropriate choice. So I wanted to do that. And then the second one, O Welt, ich muss dich lassen, means O world, I must leave thee, which Brahms says, you can almost hear him leaving the setting, leaving the world, as it plays a phrase of the chorale, echoes it, and echoes the last note even softer. And he just goes through the whole chorale, playing one phrase, just beautifully harmonizing that lush Brahms chromaticism, then a medium echo, then a really soft echo, until it just dies away. Finally, the last piece on the program is Durafle's epic suite. I picked this because it was my final piece I played on my last degree recital at IU, and I wanted to share it with all of you. And honestly, it's hard enough. I wanted to do it again, so I have to reward the months of work I put into it at school. A few things about the suite. You'll hear the prelude is this brooding, tense storm that doesn't really resolve. It builds up to a big crescendo and then just dies away, still waiting for something to happen. The Sicilian is a beautiful, lilting melody that goes through various transformations and transitions. And finally, the Toccata is a fiery tour de force that Durafle, being the notorious, cynical self-critic that he was, infamously hated. This happened with many of Durafle's compositions. After he published them, he changed his mind on them and said they were no good. There's a very funny story. He and his wife were being interviewed, and the interviewer asked him about his Toccata, and he said, it's like a meal composed of rotten meat, because the theme is bad. To which his wife responded, maybe, but the sauce is exquisite. So I hope you enjoy. I do not share Durafle's low opinion of his Toccata, and I agree with his wife, so I hope you enjoyed the suite as much as I do. Thank you.